anyways, too. But yeah, overall, this thing, it runs and rides, I mean, just super nice, guys. Really doesn't do justice. I wish everyone had the opportunity to ride one of these bikes. You know, for the price point that they're at, it's not bad. I wonder if you guys thought there's a new bike. It's called, it's a Cove MX250. And, looks really nice. It's right around, it's like $59.99 MSRP. It's an electric start. It's a claimed like 216 pound dry weight, which is the lightest 250. It's claimed right around 40 horsepower. So all those numbers would be pretty groundbreaking for the motocross industry, if everything kind of goes through. So yeah, let me know. I'm gonna try to include a picture of it and see what you guys think about it. I actually reached out to Cole to see if we could maybe do a deal or something and get our hands on a bike. You know, even if it's just a discounted bike or whatnot, I'd love to try one out. ATM hour meter on this thing. Still, this thing's just so goddamn fun to ride. This thing doesn't have the power of my 250 does. Still have to add much fun though. Acceleration bumps coming out of there. But yeah, this thing, guys, is probably my favorite bike to ride. I hate to say it, but I got that little stick. He's bugging the heck out of me. Oh, there's a big hole there. I was like, why did it just like die in place there? Get this guy out of the way. Also get this guy out of the way. Alright, back to riding. As I forget to turn the key off, big idiot me. This thing's still fast, guys. Like, oh, I love it. Say, but I gotta get some more time on it. I got half an hour plus, maybe an hour on it, so I got maybe an hour and a half ride time on it, seat time on it. The thing's super easy to get used to. Doesn't have much torque down off the bottom, but it revs pretty clean. That's the good part. The suspension's nice and soft, plush. I guess it shouldn't really be plush, but soft. You know, it's a trail bike, it's supposed to be comfortable. But, yeah. Let me see if my one jump's cleared off there. before, this thing's it's a glorified pit bike, guys. Basically what I describe it as. Pretty heavy, but you don't really notice it too much because the center of gravity is pretty low to the ground. See how chopped up these ruts are getting. Where am I? I guess my ruts come out of my corner here. Oh yeah. Some nice hard ones come out of there. Yeah, we were doing a little sighting in. Guns over there. Yeah, we'd shoot, 50, 100 yards, whatnot, trying to get sighted in. But yeah, we got a lot of, I wouldn't say a lot of stuff in the pipeline, but we got a decent amount of videos still that we can make up. It's just a matter of time. We have a new purchase to show you guys, which you really haven't even seen the one, but I already got rid of the one, which might have been a bad deal on my end, but we'll have to find out. Nice thing was that I wasn't in much on the bike. I guess I shouldn't say that much. I was in a little bit on it, but yeah, we'll see how that goes, and then YSR, ordering crank seals for it tonight, actually. That was we think that's the problem. Just doesn't want to tune up carbs perfectly clean, no air leaks, spray it all around for air leaks. But yeah. It's been a slow couple of months for us. We've been trying to get some stuff done around here, but I feel like once we start one project, we have two or three more that appear. And we're trying to get ready for snowmobiling season by us, which is right around the corner. So we're trying to get all prepped up and ready for that. Blessed with a 60 degree day in the beginning of November here, so I'm trying to make the most of it, try to get you guys some riding footage.